Good morning children, Sai Ram. I hope children you all are revising shlokas every day. And I know children you all are enjoying Pallu education. Am I correct children? So children, till now we have learned many stories. Can you all name the stories which we have learned? Yes. The very first story we have learned, Chubby the elephant. Yes. After that we have learned the story of King Mahabali in the lesson Raksha Bandhan. Yes. After that we have learned Mahatma Gandhi, story from the life of Mahatma Gandhi. And then we have learned the story from the life of Sai Baba. Am I correct children? I hope you all are enjoying. So children, today we will have a small recap about the story from the life of Sai Baba. So children, our today's topic is story from the life of Sai Baba of Shirdi. In the last week we have learned about Mrs. Tarkhad. Once Mrs. Tarkhad, a woman from Mumbai, had come to Shirdi for few days. As you all can see in the picture children, she was in the dining hall at that hour of noon. A hungry dog came to the door where the woman sat. That poor dog looks hungry. The woman was very kind and then she decided, I will give it a chapati. The woman at once gave a chapati from her plate to the dog. Then later, when she went to meet Sai Baba in the Dwarka Mai, how Sai Baba replied to her, "Mother, you gave me a heartly meal today. Always act thus. First give food to the hungry and then feed yourself." The woman could not understand what Sai was saying. She was quite astonished in her mind. "Baba, how could I have fed you? How could I have fed you? I am myself dependent on others for my food." Then Sai Baba replied, "Did you not give a chapati to a hungry dog? All creatures are one with me. In feeding that dog, you have fed me." So the woman was choked with emotions and her eyes filled with tears of joy. "Baba, I will never forget what I have learned today." Then Baba said, "See, God in all beings, for all are forms of the same God. Whether it is a bird, an animal or a human being, each one possesses the divine Atma." So we have learned in this story, Baba always used to say, "Sabka Malik Ek." Means the moral of the story is, God is everywhere. God is in everything. So children, in today's session, we are going to do the activity from the textbook. So children, I hope you all are ready with your pencil and your notebook. Be ready with a pencil, eraser and a notebook. Let's see Roman 1. Answer the following. Number 1. Who was Mrs. Tarkhad? I repeat children, Who was Mrs. Tarkhad? I know children, you all are very clever and you all can write the answer correctly. And the correct answer is, Mrs. Tarkhad was a woman from Mumbai who had come to Shirdi for few days. I repeat, answer, Mrs. Tarkhad was a woman from Mumbai who had come to Shirdi for few days. Okay children, now let's see question 2. What did she give the hungry dog? What did Mrs. Tarkhad gave the hungry dog? Yes, everybody know the answer. The correct answer is, she gave a chapati from her plate to the hungry dog. Answer is, she gave a chapati from her plate to the hungry dog. Now let's see question number 3. Why was Mrs. Tarkhad astonished by Sai Baba's words? Why was Mrs. Tarkhad astonished by Sai Baba's words? Yes children? Yes, and the answer is, Mrs. Tarkhad was astonished because she could not understand what Sai was saying. Yes, the correct answer is, Mrs. Tarkhad was astonished because she could not understand what Sai was saying. I hope children you all are writing with me. Now question 4. What message is conveyed through the lesson? What message is conveyed through the lesson? And the answer is, the message, God is everywhere and God is in everything, is conveyed through the lesson. Answer, the message, God is everywhere and God is in everything, is conveyed through the lesson. Now, Roman 2b. As you all know children, God has given us lots of things. That's why we should always pray to God. As we all know, God is present in everything. So, your children, you have to tell me, thank God for any three things He has given you. We are going to write three answers what God has given us. Thank God for any three things He has given you. Now children, I have written my answers, that are beautiful nature, food and shelter, health and wealth. And children, this question you are going to write your answer by your own. Now homework time. Number 1, draw any one wonderful creation of God. You will love to draw children. You will enjoy drawing. So this you are going to do at your home. Number 1, draw any one wonderful creation of God. Any of your choice, any wonderful creation of God you can draw here. Okay children, understood? All right. Number 2, narrate any kind or good deed or act which you have done. This you can write in 2-3 words. Sorry, in 2-3 lines. Any of the good deed or any kind work or your act which you have done, that you are going to write in your own words. So next period children, I am going to ask you what you have written in your notebook. So children, I hope you all must have enjoyed the session and you all are going to honestly do the homework. Okay children, so thank you so much and see you soon in the next Value Education session.